What's up, guys? It's Gathalion, and I'm playing Goat Simulator because I love Goat Simulator. And this game runs awesome on my PC. But I'm hearing from around the internet that people are having issues, and I wanted to make sort of a configuration guide or like a how to make this game run smoothly. Goat Simulator is plagued by a pretty common issue with older engine, which is Unreal Engine 3, that isn't highly optimized because this game was put together in like a week. So they didn't go through all the trouble to optimize it. Basically what happens is Goat Simulator is not a very taxing game on your computer, so it will actually underutilize hardware, and it'll make your GPU sit at a lower clock rate, and it will park CPU cores, and it won't use all your CPU cores correctly, and you'll end up getting in a situation where your hardware is just throttled, and then there are very sharp spikes in physics calculations in this game, because that's what this game was originally going to be. It was a physics demo, or it was a physics simulator to be used in-house in studio, but then it ended up being turned into a game. But I digress. There are a few things that you can do on your computer, ranging from INI configurations to actual software to hardware tweaks within your computer to make this game get just a few extra frames and be just a little bit smoother for you. And let's go over those now. The first one is gonna be configuring your INI file. All right, so we need to find the game's INI file. The first thing you're gonna wanna do is go to Documents, and you're gonna wanna find where Steam drops your game's documents, which usually in a folder called My Games within your Documents folder. From there, you're gonna wanna go to Goat Sim, and inside Goat Sim to Goat Game. From Goat Game, you're gonna wanna go to your Config folder, and then you're gonna wanna go to goatengine.ini. In there, the first thing we're gonna wanna do is go to Edit, and then Find, and then you're gonna wanna search for Physics. Now, we're gonna look for an option called Disable Physics Hardware. Now, normally this is set to true. Setting it to true will disable any sort of hardware enabled or accelerated physics effects. Now, if you are using an AMD card, or you're just running off of an integrated card, you're gonna wanna keep this on true because you won't have NVIDIA hardware to accelerate your physics. But I'm not even sure that this game uses hardware accelerated physics, though it does say NVIDIA physics in the first splash screen, so there's really no harm in setting it to false. Setting it to false does enable hardware accelerated physics, and I've seen this make things be a little bit smoother on certain games, and there's really no harm, no foul in seeing if it works on this game. I set it to false because I have an NVIDIA card, so let's just keep going from here. The next thing we're gonna wanna find is the word smooth. Now, smooth makes you think it'll be smooth, but not always. We're gonna look for an option called Smooth Frame Rate. Now, normally it is set to true, and then the bottom two are set to 32 and 60. 32 being the minimum smooth frame rate and 60 being the top, meaning it will cap your frames at 60, but it will try to find a sweet spot between 32 and 60, which often leads to a less than desirable play experience because it will keep you around top end 30 to 45 frames per second, but still keep you capped at 60, meaning you're not gonna go above 60, meaning when you hit a frame dip, you're gonna go below 60 frames per second. Now, if you wanna completely uncap your frame rate, you wanna set smooth frame rate to false, and then min and max to zero. Or if you wanna keep a smooth frame rate, keep a nice high frame target, you could go ahead and set smooth frame rate to true, and then you could go ahead and set your minimum smooth frame rate to something around 90, or your max smooth frame rate to around 120. Though playing uncapped just seems to be the best way to do it. Either one of these will give you a better experience than the lower smooth frame rate, and I would really recommend against using it. All right, the last couple things we're gonna take a look at are sort of hardware control through software, and don't worry, none of these are really going to hurt your computer. The first thing we're gonna look at is core parking. Now, I have a neat little utility called Park Control, which unparks cores. What is core parking? Well, in modern processors, there is a function that will pretty much deactivate certain cores in your CPU if it feels that they are being underutilized. This is to save power. Why is this bad for some games? Well, some games have sharp spikes in activity, and reactivating those cores generally might add a little bit of stutter to your game, and then they will throttle back down when things are not too active. By fully unparking your cores, they will not throttle down and they will always be active. This will not affect your temperatures at all because they are still controlled by temperature restraints. And as I have seen when using park control, I have not had any negative effects from using this utility. Again, I'll have a link to it in the description. It is fully 100% safe. Unparking your cores will not hurt your PC. Though, if you feel like just going back to the way it was, just hit enable and it'll go ahead and re-enable CPU parking. But this really helps in a lot of older games with sharp spikes in activity. Like I said, in Goat Simulator, it does have sharp spikes in physics calculations. So when those parked cores get activated, there is a bit of stuttering. Now, the last thing we're gonna wanna look at is this is in EVGA Precision X. You might be using MSI Afterburner. I'm not sure what the equivalent for this is on there. If you know, feel free to leave it in a comment and I'll give you a thumbs up on that so other people can read it. But this is my issue. Goat Simulator does not utilize the GPU entirely. And the GPU clock will end up being under what it is maximum. Now, you could either set a frame rate target, which I've found to not be super useful. You could set it to 120 frames per second, but I find that still leaves the GPU underclocked, and you're really not getting all the oomph out of your GPU. This is the tweak that I've gotten the most frames out of. I actually ended up getting a solid 10 frames out of this tweak. You could always overclock your GPU, but if you're not getting the entire clock rate on it, then you're really not gonna see those frames. There is a option under voltage for EVGA Precision X called K-Boost. And K-Boost basically locks your clock rate at the boost clock rate, which keeps it running at maximum performance and maximum clock and maximum voltage at all times, meaning that there is no throttling, there is no drop. In small loads, it won't drop below, and then there won't be any hitches when you throttle back up to times of high action. And yeah, if you do enable K-Boost, it will have to reset your computer, and we're gonna go ahead and do that now. Now that I have K-Boost activated, you can see that my clock rate on my GPU is at maximum at all times. The only downside of this is when you're at idle, you will be a little bit warmer on your GPU, but nothing extreme, about 10 to 15 degrees Celsius. But when you are at full utilization on a high-end game, you will not see any increase in temperature to your GPU. All you will see is that it does not clock down during times of low utilization, which makes it so there's no throttling and there's none of that frame loss when it has to boot back up into full use. And also this will keep it at its full and powerful clock rate at all times. So that'll about wrap it up, guys. Hopefully this guide is helping you get at least a few extra frames out of Goat Simulator. And yes, it is pretty much an unoptimized game, which is what we expected, but I thought I would help you guys out with a few quick tips and tricks and optimization tweaks for it. Don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you guys later.